Welcome, everybody. I appreciate you that you are watching, and welcome to part two of the love factor. You need to know that you are a priority before God. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1 to 3, it talks about the issue of love. And it talks about us, that even though we speak in foreign tongues and talk in the language of God and angels, and even though we talk and we prophesy and we declare and decree things to happen and they happen, and even though we are there to know all the mysteries of the kingdom of God and the mysteries of science and the mysteries of humanity, and if we have no love, he says, then it amounts to nothing. The money, the good works, the benevolence that people do, the philanthropic assignments that many men and women across the globe do, if the motivation is not the motivation of love, I want them to know it amounts to nothing. We can give every percentage of our wealth, but if the motivation is not about the love for humanity and the love for people and the love for the vulnerable and the love for others, our acts of goodness and benevolence, they mean nothing before God. God doesn't approve an act if not done in love. He doesn't approve any act of goodness. He doesn't approve any acts of words of goodness if they are not motivated in love. We miss it. There are some of us who like even making jokes, fun of others. I want you to know that you need to look at every human being with the love of God and see them with the lenses of God. In which sense did God show his love and a priority to human beings? In which sense? How did he show it up? Number one, he did it by sacrificially giving the best. He gave the best, his only begotten son, as a priority to you human beings. There is no sacrifice worthy, human beings, except the sacrifice of Jesus. There are people who sacrifice children. There are people who sacrifice animals. There are people who sacrifice birds. There are people who sacrifice money. There are people who sacrifice their careers. There are people who sacrifice things for God. But all those sacrifices cannot overcome the sacrifice that God gave of his only begotten son. Through that sacrifice, which was best of Christ, we see God's priority for humanity. But number two, he did it lavishly. So the lavish love of God speaks of the factor of love that he demonstrates to you and me, that he is making you a priority. Your life is a priority. He cares about you. Man, lady, God has made you a priority. He's made us a priority. He lovingly does these things. Imagine he has given you life, even though you don't deserve it. Imagine he releases his rains to fall on everyone, to rain everywhere, even though they are actually contrary and rebellious to him. Imagine he allows his sunshine to enjoy, we enjoy the sunshine, even though we are contrary to him. It is because of the lavishness of the nature of the love of God. But number three, he demonstrated this love towards us, that he has a best plan for humanity. He has the best plan for you. He plans the best for you. In Jeremiah 33:11, he says, I know the plans. Actually, it's not even Jeremiah 33. But in Jeremiah 29:11, he says, I know the plans I have for you. He knows the plans he has for you. From the beginning, he ordained you for the best. Don't hurt yourself. Don't harm yourself. Don't harm others. Don't hurt that child. Don't destroy your neighbor. You, I mean you, you are God's priority. He's seeking out for you. Are you lost? Did you fail to find the way? Did you miss the mark? He is reaching out to you. Will you allow him to hold your hand today? It is a love factor. You are a priority to God. Surrender your life to Jesus. He so loves you so much. He loves us so much. In the midst of what is happening, He is mindful of you. He is mindful of me. He is mindful of the people. He is mindful of the neighbors. He is so mindful of us. It is the love factor. He makes you His priority. Will you make Him your priority? Submit to Him. May God bless you as you make a choice on following Him. For that is the love factor. Amen.